You're inside Playhouse Disney.
Christopher, time for school.
Okay, Mom.
Come, cuddly Tino.
Who could that be now?
Humming a melody.
Could it be Who Dare?
Maybe it's Pooh Bear.
Pooh? Well, that's me.
He's Winnie the Pooh.
Come and find me.
He's Winnie the Pooh. He's in the book. He's Winnie the Pooh.
Your name remind me.
Everyone knows he's Winnie the Pooh.
He's Winnie the Pooh.
And all my friends here.
He's Winnie the Pooh.
Come have a look.
He's Winnie the Pooh.
The fun never ends here.
Everyone knows he's Winnie the Pooh.
It was springtime, the time when gardens are planted, and no one loved gardening more than Rabbit.
Yeah. My, you must really love gardening, Rabbit.
What? Oh, good morning, Piglet. Yes, there is something almost magical about the way that plants start as a little seed. Every flower, every branch, every fruit the plant will ever have is all wrapped up in that tiny seed. Magical indeed.
But the seeds look so alike, Rabbit. How do you know which seeds will turn into which plants?
I make a little sign out of the seed packet. Like this.
Oh, I see. So the row over there with the watermelon sign are watermelons. And that row with the cucumber sign are cucumbers.
Yes, Piglet. And that's not the only kind of sign a gardener needs to watch out for. I wake up every morning and face a brand new day. I watch for the sign of rain or shine to come this way, so I'll know.
So you'll know.
And when it's time for planting, I watch for signs of spring, for budding seeds, for sprouting reeds, and the bounty they will bring. I watch for signs to help my garden grow. I watch for every sign on every leaf and vine.
Oh,
I rely on the signs from on high for this little patch of mine.
It's a very nice patch, too.
And when it's nearly ripened, I watch for signs to see if it's time to pick. I can do it quick, for the signs are telling me. That's how I reap and sow.
Oh.
I watch for signs and help my garden grow. I watch for signs and help my garden grow. Ah, there. All I do now is water the garden, and in a few weeks I'll harvest all these wonderful crops.
Oh, I'm looking forward to seeing them.
As am I. As am I, Piglet. Well, goodbye.
Goodbye, Rabbit. Oh, dear. That sounds like... Tigger! Look at Rabbit's garden.
You're right there, little Piglet. It's all methificated. I wonder what happened.
Well, you bounced me, Tigger.
We'll just have to fix it all up good as new before old Longears gets a chance to get his tail in a cotton ball.
Oh, dear.
One of these little pictures are impertinent.
Yes, they're very important, Tigger. They mark which plants grow out of which rows.
Well, then we'll just stick them back in the ground.
Oh. row, but we don't know which sign goes with which row.
Oh, yes, but don't you worry, my little worry warthog. Don't you know potatoes have eyes? Oh, yeah, they'll tell the other vegetables which sign to grow under.
Well, if you say so, Tigger.
Sure, not to worry, my boy. See, we got it all fixated. Everything's okie-dokie.
Well, many weeks passed, and Rabbit's seeds grew into lush green plants. Rabbit, of course, was quite pleased with himself.
Well, of course. Wouldn't you be? Everything just looks so nice. In fact, I think I'll harvest the crops tomorrow.
You hear that, Piglet? Bunny Boy's garden is fine as frogs here.
I guess you were right, Tigger.
Wait a minute. Something's not right. Usually my corn stalks are much taller than this. And these radishes are growing vines. Oh, my. Did I use the wrong fertilizer?
Tigger!
Great Caesar salad. I spoke too soon. Floppy ears vegetables don't know what they're supposed to be anymore. Oh, Rabbit's gonna be hopping mad.
Oh, dear.
But don't worry, little curly tail. Old Tigger's got another plan. My later plans are always better than my earlier ones. Just watch.
Oh, hi. Yes, yes. Something's definitely very wrong. Oh, dear.
Say, flouncy ears, what say you and me go on a camping trip? You know, overnight for a few months. You look like you could use some restful relaxificatin'.
Why, that's very nice of you, Tigger, but this is an important time. The harvest is coming up tomorrow.
I hate to say this, Bunny Boy, but this gardening is too much work. You should start a more normal hobby, like collecting used bubblegum and dust bunnies. What do you think?
No, Tigger, no. I love gardening. It's not just a hobby. It's also my food supply and my great joy. Now, if you'll excuse me, my garden needs me.
My other plan didn't work, Piglet. Maybe it wasn't later enough.
Well, I think it's getting later all the time, Tigger. We've got to do something.
Light bulb! Not to worry, Piglet. I've got another plan, and this one is the very latest of all.
Late that night, Piglet and Tigger crept into Rabbit's garden.
Oh, dear. I'm still not sure what we're doing here, Tigger.
Oh, simple little buddy. We're gonna paint all the vegetables with harmless, non-toxico food coloring so they look like the signs at the end of the rows. See? All this here little green thing he needs is some stripedies, and then it'll look just like a watery melon. That way everything will match up extra exactly.
Well, if you say so, Tigger.
Well, of course I say so.
So Tigger and Piglet painted all the crops different colors. And the next morning...
Good day for a harvest, huh, Rabbit? Nothing wrong with this garden, no siree, Bob.
Yes, well, I have no idea who Bob is, but I'm certainly very anxious to see how my potatoes turn out. Good grief. My nice round potatoes are all long and pointy. It almost looks like a carrot.
Oh, that's because it really is a painted carrot.
And my carrots, so stumpy. My garden has never produced such a horrible crop before.
Hello, Rabbit.
Oh, hello, Pooh. Oh, woe is me. I've lost my touch. Oh, dear. Oh, my. I guess there's just one thing to do.
What? Hey there, Cottontail. What's with all the boxes?
Rabbit, are you moving out?
Yes, I'm afraid so. The way I see it, nobody needs a rabbit who can't garden. So I guess it's time to move on. Maybe I would be better at collecting used gum.
But, Rabbit, you're a wonderful gardener.
Yeah, you're the gardeniest gardener I know.
But you see, I'm not. My watermelons look like cucumbers. My carrots are the shape of radishes, and look! My potatoes might as well be carrots.
Yes, the potatoes do look like carrots. Why, except for their color, I'd say this was a carrot. And look. Well, this one peels just like an ear of corn.
Yes, Pooh. These vegetables are right inside, but they're wrong outside. Oh, dear. It's even worse than I thought. What have I done?
Tigger, I think we should tell now.
Tell what, Tigger?
Well, the potatoes kind of look like carrots because of I accidentally bounced Piglet and mixed up all the signs.
You what?
Yes, and the vegetables got all confused when the signs weren't right. And
please don't be mad at us, Rabbit. Well, he's got some sense of humor for a guy with no garden.
Yes. What's so funny, Rabbit?
I'd like to know that, too.
It's just that... oh, dear. The seeds already know what they're going to grow into. The signs are just to remind me what I planted where. This garden is fine. In fact, it might just be my best crop ever. Oh, dear. Well, I guess I can throw this away now, can't I?
No, keep it. You could use it on that great vegetable stand you're gonna have to open.
Say, Tigger, that's not a bad idea. Not a bad idea.
It's not a bad idea.
It was a day much like any other in the 100-acre wood, and everyone...
Down here!
Down here!
Down here!
Down here! Look at stripes!
Look, it's Pooh and his friends Piglet, Tigger, and Rabbit.
Tell him, Pooh.
Yes, Mr. Narrator, we were just listening to what you were saying.
Yes?
And it occurred to us that, what we were listening to wasn't... true.
Ooh, I see. And which part was that? That wasn't true, I mean.
The part where you said, it was a day much like any other, I believe.
Yes, exactly.
It is the part.
Yes. Don't you see anything unusual on this page of the book?
Unusual? Oh, yes, I see. It's page 100.
Now all we gotta do is find something proper to commemorate the occasional
Well, I've often heard a cake is a very good thing to have on a special occasion.
Cake is?
Yes, a cake.
Is scrumptious.
I think a cake is a grand idea.
Then a cake it is. A page 100 in the 100-acre wood very special day cake.
You know, Friend Owl is rather wise. Perhaps he knows how to bake a cake.
Owl, of course.
Let's go see Big Lips right now.
Oh, dear. I can't possibly go right now. I have some cleaning up to do. If there's going to be a celebration.
I will help you, Piglet.
And my cabbages need watering.
Boy, what a bunch of party padoopers. Well, I'm going now, so I'll be mustard and you can catch up.
Oh, page 100, you say? Well, that certainly is a milestone worthy of a cake. And I'm always delighted to share my knowledge of the culinary arts, which, as you may or may not be aware, is quite extensive.
Okay, fine. Just get to the part about the cakey.
Of course. Down to business. Now, you're going to need eggs, oil, water, cake mix, a mixing bowl, a cake pan, and some frosting.
Frosting? Oh, boy, that's the job for me, because everyone knows that frosting is the bestest part of the cake. Make way for one frosty Tigger.
Tigger, that's not all there is. Oh, dear, this won't do at all. Pooh Bear, thank goodness you've come.
Greetings, Owl. I've come to learn about cakes. You see, it's page
100. Yes, I know all about it. Now, listen closely. The most difficult thing about cakes is making the batter.
Making it batter? Oh, I've never made a cake before, Owl. So you may be certain it will be the best one I have ever made.
No, not better. Batter.
batter. I mean, oh dear. Batter is the gooey stuff you get when you mix all the ingredients together in a bowl.
You mean there's more to the batter than just eggs?
Oh, my, yes. There is cake mix and oil and water and...
Well, you know, Owl, with three things in my hands, it's very hard to keep more things in my brain.
But someone has to know all the instructions.
Oh,
Pooh, are you all right?
Oh, yes. And the eggs are fine, too, Owl.
Owl, I need to know about
cakes. Yes, yes, I know. And let me just say, I'm not going to give you a single ingredient until you promise to listen to all my instructions.
Of course I will, Owl. If you think I'm going to leave it up to Tigger, Pooh, and Piglet to take care of, you're mistaken. I'm the responsible one, you know.
Aha! Excellent! Good! Wonderful! Then I shall put you in charge of bringing the cake mix. Oh, and this pan is for pouring the batter into.
What batter?
That's what I've been trying to tell everyone. The batter is what you get when you mix all the ingredients. See? You start with this cake mix, then add water.
Water? Well, say no more.
But
watering is my business. Leave it all to me, Owl.
Oh, why won't anyone listen to the whole recipe?
Oh, hello, Owl. Do you have a headache?
Piglet, not anymore, dear fellow, for you are going to listen to all of my cake recipe, aren't you?
Oh, naturally.
Superb! Now hold this mixing bowl while I explain all. The first thing you do is empty your cake mix and oil into the bowl. Then you add your eggs and water and stir it all briskly. Pour the batter into the baking pan. And then you put the baking pan in the oven at 350 degrees for 30 minutes and you're done. Did you get all that, Piglet?
Uh-huh. 350 degrees for 30 minutes.
Correct. Now off with you, my friend, and bon appetit. At last, I finally told someone the whole recipe.
Of course, we know that not one single person had heard the whole recipe. So when our friends tried to make the cake, well, just watch.
Well, where shall we start?
Well, I've got the frosting, and I'm supposed to slobber it under cake.
But we don't even have a cake yet.
Oh, yeah. That would be a problem, bunny boy.
All right, then. So how do we make the cake?
I remember Owl telling me to put the baking pan in the oven.
Then let's do it, Piglet.
Somehow it doesn't look right.
Maybe something should go in the cake pan before we bake it.
Oh, of course. We have to mix the batter. I distinctly remember something about batter.
Way to doodle it out, puppy drawers. Okay, so how do we mix the batter?
Owl told me to put the eggs in the bowl with the other ingredients.
Oh dear.
Does that look like batter to you?
Maybe we should try mixing them, Pooh.
Oh, dear, this isn't working. Tigger, you went to Owl's first. Why didn't you get the whole recipe?
Me? Pooh Boy should have paid more attention.
But I thought Piglet would get the missing information because he visited Owl last, you see.
Me?
I'm the frosting guy.
This isn't getting us anywhere. Doesn't anybody have a positive suggestion?
Well, it seems to me that each of us got a little bit of information from Owl, and, well...
Go on, Piglet, you're doing wonderfully.
Oh, thank you, Pooh. I was also thinking that if we shared all of what we know and worked like a team...
We'll be able to bake the cake.
I brought the eggs.
And I brought the water.
And I set the temperature and time to bake.
And I put the pan in the oven.
Cause we're having a party and we need a cake. We're making a cake, a mighty good cake.
I told you it wouldn't be that hard to make.
Just a stir and a scramble and a mix and a shake. A beautiful, wonderful, marvelous cake.
Look at it rise.
As light as a feather.
I just can't wait until it's done.
You couldn't have done it without old Tigger. We couldn't have done it without everyone.
We're making the cake, a mighty good cake.
Working together, it's a cinch to make.
It's as easy as pie.
It's a piece of cake.
A beautiful, wonderful, marvelous cake. Yes, we're making the cake, a mighty good cake.
I can already see the bite I want to take.
With a stir and a scramble
and a mix
and a shake,
we're making a beautiful, fabulous, glorious, wonderful, marvelous,
very meritorious,
beautiful, marvelous cake.
Yes,
you're
right. Now you're
talking.
It's
a large cake, please. Oh, that sure looks yumulous.
I vote for eating it.
Our page 100 in the 100 Acre Wood Very Special Day cake. Impressive, I think. I'm ready to try it.
Just one thing.
Which thing, Piglet?
Well, I certainly don't like being the one with bad news, but,
Well, then,
go
don't
ahead,
say it.
Piglet.
Well, we aren't on page 100 anymore.
Oh, dear, he's right.
We certainly
are.
Wow, who would have thunk it could take 10 whole pages to bake a cake?
Oh, 110. Well, what do we do now?
Well, if I may make a suggestion, page 110 is just as good a reason to eat cake as page 100.
You know what?
Yes. You got
yes,
that right, buddy boy.
Hooray! Sign for everything and everything under its sign. How does that go? Let's see. A sign by any other name? No.
We learned quite a bit today about the importance of signs, didn't we, Rabbit?
Huh? Oh, yes, we did indeed. Signs are extremely important.
They can be large or small, but whatever the size, signs help us remember what things are for.
Unless someone switches them around. Oh, we also learned about recipes.
That's right. A recipe is a list of ingredients.
And directions for how to put the ingredients together. We used a recipe to make a cake. It did take us a while to get everything in the right order, though.
But you did get the job done.
Oh, true. Now, let me see. Where was I? Oh, yes. A sign. A sign. My kingdom for a sign. No, that's not it.
Now's the time to close the book.
Though we've just begun, it's true.
We'll say goodbye until another day.
Another day with new adventures on the way.
They're on the way.
We're on our way.
So off we go. We won't be far. We'll be waiting here for you.
With hills to run
and higher trees to climb.
And someone there to catch you.
Up next, spend some time with Pooh, Piglet, and Eeyore, too, in the Book of Pooh, right here inside Playhouse Disney.
We'll meet again when you all come into the Book of Pooh.
Next, there's more Pooh, Piglet, and Tigger, too, as the Book of Pooh marathon continues.